you're in trouble because you're immediately down to 4 players instead of 5. Nice job from Long, Captain Long, really waiting over there. Steno pushing up, Rosie looking for a nice hit on Vanessa, but just not getting underneath before falling to the ground. So far. Okay. Like I said, this is just me and I've got to do the technical things, and if anybody's seen the last game that I did where I had to do the technical stuff as well as speak, it did not go very well. Right split there from Kim and Lauren, teammates on Sunday League, teammates on Tuesday League. Alyssa getting knocked out by Rosie there. Captain's on opposite wings. Sveno getting caught. The bad blood between former teammates, Sveno and Lani, on the Valkyrie days. Vanessa getting caught back in and playing a beautiful hit. Dodgy birds to get the first set. Yep, I know how to do things. Alright, set back up. Back at it again. There it is. The much more defensive approach from the Dropbears, which is what you want. You've only got 5 players. You don't need to throw off the rush, so just make sure you get safe, get those. Good defensive lining, and a nice double from the Dropbears to take out Vanessa on the left wing, right wing. Left from where I'm looking. Alyssa. Bit of a groan there as she actually turns into the ground. Down the line. Rosie looking very intimidating, protecting team back through. To get the ball there. And Lani will take the out. Sveno getting the bad blood back. This is never gonna die. Rosie losing her ball and catching Erica. Alyssa getting hit out by Rosie with a nice little catch into a hit. Ruby, four balls, straight down the line, Sveno not finding it. And three balls. Lauren pressure out, Alyssa finding a nice throw. Lauren moving forward, just getting out of the way of it. Rosie looking for her go down the line. Immediate counter, looking into the middle, not finding it. Lauren can trade it. I think it may have bounced first, but she immediately took the out, so potentially not. Lauren versus the world, there's no one to tell me not. So here we are. It will be a nice job. Clean it up. The old Dropbears coming in to take the last set. Currently 1-1, as you can see on the screen there. First half, about 15 minutes to go. Give or take maybe a couple seconds. I think we're a second. 2 seconds. second faster than the actual game time. But it should give you a good representation. Four balls on the side of Dropbears. Shout out to the unsung heroes, the Shaggers. Committing two on this seemed like there was a bit of a miscommunication. Both didn't seem to go at the same player. Just between the goalposts, as it were. Nice double. Vanessa finds one, and Alyssa and Lauren find a nice hit on Drew. There will be four. Then some good fakes in. Steno, a bit intimidated.
Rush, but
Dodgeball was not active. So she will be back in. A triple on using them sick dodgeball skills. Going, I'm not going to get out. I need to win the game. I want a gold medal. Svetter in the right position just bounces onto Alyssa's toes.
Rosie down the line.
Marnie's turn. Good block from Laura. Bit of a cannon coming out. I see more people are joining us. Listen to me ramble while you watch the dodgeball. Drew with a block. Drew with a nice block. Rosie with a nice block. Just not finding Vanessa. Had her in good position. Well-positioned throw, but Vanessa just waiting that split second to go backwards. To not run into it. Gio with a nice cross, finding Lauren on the left shadow position from camera view. Right shadow in actuality. Just a trade close of near misses, I guess. It's 9 viewers, hell yeah. Actually 8 viewers because I think my quality is wonderful. But still. Glad for everybody to turn up. Vanessa down the line. Gio and Rosie. Nice little 1-2 punch to take out Erica there as he tries to cover her teammate. Setting up Rosie again. As we saw in the semi-final last week, Rosie was an absolute fire. Really carried her team to victory. So unlucky. You hate to see it when you're on fire, and I accidentally jinxed her, let's be honest. But it just rolling off Alyssa's leg. To the waiting rooms. Hit into her feet as it went down. And it is Gio McKay versus Royal. Another nice block from Lauren. There were 3 on the side of the Dodgy Birds. And their potential chance to take the highest lead in this game thus far. But Gio's got something to say in it. Telling her team to chill out. Let's get the easy money. And a nice double. The Dodgy Birds take a commanding lead. So, here we go. I think there's a little bit of static or something, so I apologize for that if you are listening to my voice. I am good with computers, hardware and software, so we're trying to figure it out. Spend it with a nice block. Rosie coming up, Gio taking that error from the backside. Just under 5 minutes. Dodgy Birds are taking their time. run looking through down the middle. Looking for one on Geo, not finding it. Nice catch from Vanessa Brings Alyssa. Well, we traded an Alyssa for an Alyssa. Alyssa Grover gets caught out. Alyssa Chow comes back in. A nice catch. Look to be a bit of a right there, but her legs coming in clutch. Gia with a nice catch. Rosie could have jumped into court and grabbed that. Decided not to. Play it safe, but Gia with a nice catch, bringing the set back in, bringing a heavy hitter in. A triple down the center. Erica just on the side there from Drew. Nice throw.
We're playing.
I think I found the problem, ladies and gentlemen. Hang on just 2 seconds. That and just use this, I think this will be much better and there'll be no static. A nice double from Rosie and Drew comes in, finds a good hit, not a good hit, finds a, oh my god, I'm getting all turned around because I'm trying to fix this, but it is 4-3, current score. It's 3 points to the Dodgy Birds. Vanessa finding another one, getting a nice catch, similar in the way of the first one. On Rosie this time. And it does bring Captain Long back in. So that is good. So, here with a nice round from Alyssa. Just not finding purchase. Keeps it kosher. Marley looking for a nice one. Trying to get the ball coming out of the body. And down the line. Almost finds Lonnie. 3 balls on the side of...
What place is that?
Dodgy Birds. Both their names start with D.
Right, 7, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Alright, Sunday, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. It's game time. Gio really needs to clutch this out. I didn't mean to say that so loudly. Go under again. Lauren very close to that line. I don't think Marcus was looking right at it. He didn't pull her out, so he'll rest tonight. Marcus and Wilbur. One of them will be playing in the men's grand final. I won't tell you which one. And Gio gets taken out.
Downing action.
Because you can't get out of the way if gravity's taking it in.
Score moves to 4-2. Dodgy Birds are still up.
Left side, green! Right side, green!
He goes for it. Just misses.
Oh, error.
Just gets it, actually.
Plenty of luck. Sveno looking for Kim, who was down on the ground.
Very, very close to that activation on there. Looks like it was active. Good positioning from there.
Good.
Dropbears playing with five, so it's better than losers. Lose on right at the start, it's a big deficit.
Exactly.
Meanwhile, you get Nessa nice and early, that is a big bonus for you. So. Good on them, they make it a 4v5, taking out the right wing. Ooh. Centers at Rosie, so it counters inwards. No one finds anything, but everyone is really close. I think if these girls had a little bit longer hair, so they'd be better.
Truly. Take the Kim approach, or the draw approach, keep it all nice and bunked up.
Not Alyssa, she's got Rapunzel there.
Yeah. Was it last week when we were talking about?
Yeah, we were. I think it was.
Because I was like, the braids are just so long. First world problem. Advantage coming up, Erica. Vanno looking down the line, looking to take out a football team.
Yeah, we've lost one.
They used to play on Valkyries together.
Oh.
And Lani Porter back in 1857. And the dinosaurs still weren't
here. Gio was off.
Two goals!
Is that a double nut? They're all cool and a triple because Kim just hopped over it. About a triple nutmeg there.
Woo.
It's good throwing, but no hits.
Keeping that wide stance.
Ooh. Oh! Alyssa tumbles and Drew makes her back. What's that?
Do be like that sometimes.
Timing on that split there. Only just with the first dodge, second block. That's how you really want to deal with those staggers.
They're drilling.
Agonizingly close to Rosie again. Meanwhile, both wings, Alex and Gio, throw it at Kim. Put her out.
And I think that's what probably kept them going, being so close to getting her every single time. Because 90% of the time, you probably go, all right, after the second one, we ain't hitting this person. Let's move on to someone else.
There's a good catch.
Rosie nice plus catch. One. Brings Alyssa back in.
Dropbears just still playing with the five tonight, missing seven again.
Yeah, who are they missing again?
Seven, I just said that.
Her name is Seven.
Yes. Not Seven the number, Seven.
Oh! Okay. I thought you meant they were missing seven as in like...
They have a squad of 12? Okay, come on mate.
No, like they're missing two players.
No, they're anyway. Missing seven.
Gotcha. My apologies, Seven. Seven?
Rose is pronounced the Seven on our team, so... That's what I'm going with.
Sure, we'll take it. I'm not here, so we don't need to worry about it.
Davis.
Try to look
cool.
Ooh. Where's even the no look?
Oh, here she comes.
She's zooming. Gio should have cleaned her up.
Even if Gio got traded out by Lauren on the punish, I take
it. Take it.
Black shot there.
Lauren, doing some very nice blocking tonight. Some solid one move blocking. Gio just narrowly hopped over. Almost fell into it, honestly. No, that's because I need a tool. Speed, words. I don't know what's happening with the mic. I'm just trying my best here.
Two through before. Dodgy Birds have been a lot of work to do. They are still up, so this will be a crushing set if they can extend their lead again.
They definitely want to look for the middle.
I think the Dropbears could probably only afford in the second half to drop one set.
Yeah.
Any more than that, it'd be crushing time.
But this set is stagnating a little bit. Just over 10 minutes. Lani just keeps sending it down the line, looking for Svenner. Currently not finding it. Lauren and Drew.
Sort of scaring each other. Yeah, both go for the quick take.
And that would be one ball on the side of Drop Bear. If you want to go for birds, you probably just take the
chance. Oh, Gio!
Gio with a quick counter, looks for the nice catch. Just squares up straight.
Yeah, I think the girls just need a touch more patience. Good block.
That's a hard one.
Oh.
Dropping him. Should be four ball. One versus five, definitely want to just try and waste as much time as humanly possible if you don't win the set. Which can she might. She's letting him rip. She's in Beyblades.
Oh, boy.
I wasn't gonna commentate this game, but there was no one else here. So I was like,
still, is your team winning the final?
Lost 6-9.
Which team did you play?
We got a throwback. We had him on the ropes. Anyway, let's focus. We did have him on the ropes, so we'll just let it go.
Wait, focus.
Jimmy exists. Anyway, that's all I'm saying. That is the upcoming men's final, which will be commencing on Thursday. But in the moment, this hit, nice little dipper. Drew in good shadow position. Lulling even from the back of the court, which is not a good idea if you don't want to get caught by a Rosie or a Drew who are quite.
She seems to have been to Legoland. She's got blocks.
Damn it, Lonnie. And we will be having a time out on the side of the Dodgy Bears.
You did so well. Yeah.
They're like, hang on a minute. We might have to
be look, two sets in a row for the Dropbears.
Yeah.
4-3, 1-point game.
Yeah.
We've got 8 minutes left to play.
We've got a thing.
Yeah.
Like, if you dodge birds on the ground. I've been
like
messing with them
for the
tricky. Yeah, it's difficult.
Yeah.
Anyway.
It's not.
So, the Dropbears just won two sets in a row. What have they done better than they did in the first half?
4-1 now. I think they've committed a little bit more to this defensive game.
Yep, so they just survived a bit better.
Just surviving, you know, in the first couple sets that they lost down to four players immediately, like Drew getting like maybe one or two sets in a row, or like two or three sets in a row, sorry. And just like really committing to like not overextending. You know, take those counters from the back. You've got enough power in your throw to get it across there.
Yeah. We know that the women play on an 8-meter court instead of a 9-meter court.
So, you're only throwing 16 meters. But more than likely, the person you're throwing will be up a bit more. So, you know. Lani, getting out of the way of a double. Yeah, just playing a bit more of a conservative game.
Especially start the time.
Always. Sorry, everybody. Don't put me on Facebook.
A little hop from Ness there, over one, over two. She's stays safe. Setting four balls. Do with them. Oh, a little bit.
Look,
that was three solos.
That was three solos.
It did not work at all. That was a bad play.
That was not gonna
triple
play. Very good take there.
They're just sending it somewhere in the middle without a ball.
And I like the delayed solo from Rosie. Vanessa
almost picked up the ball. The head push she has up her sleeve. Thought they released, and now it is the drop bears.
Sorry,
the dodgy bears.
Oh, the dodgy bears!
Oh, it's so easy.
Oh, it's so easy to not mix them up.
End me.
You've got egg on your face.
Look, this is the close team coming up with
and far with the kick. A little less of a good triple there from finding any hits.
You've got to find balls, you got to find one.
You do. A nice little dip from Ryan.
And you know, it does not have to be the wing. It does not have to be the captain. It does not have to be the best player. Get a hit, put like number pressure. They're already down a player every set.
Yeah.
Two hits and they're, you know, on ice.
Correct.
Just get them as they come. A little bit of a switch around. Lonnie moves up to the wing. Oh, Lonnie stacks that right side. Wants to put a bit of work into Gio. Two most experienced players in herself and Vanessa.
Almost fell out of court and blocked into her captain.
That was a nice synchronized. Ooh. Mainly because she was very, very close to that line.
Very close. 5, 4, 3
Just a solo.
Lauren down the wing, fine.
Bit conservative. Gio takes it nice and early. If I'm gonna do that, maybe roll the ball carrier.
Yeah.
Lighting was a bit ready for it. Maybe Kim will listen with a bit of his head. Oh, nice look from Kim.
Brings Erica back in.
She does. After her throw just squares up, seeing the spinner has thrown her last couple counters inwards a bit. Ah, now Lani wants to win.
And I think the bad blood has gotten to her a little bit.
Look, I think Lani might just be following Rosie. I'm not exactly sure what the switch is. Good fake.
I think my only thought is maybe Lani has taken a lot of throws at Spenner and has not broken her luck at all. So maybe she just wanted to give someone else a chance. A nice left split. A nice left split finding Rosie. So I think maybe she wanted to get away from Svenja, give someone else a chance to try and get her out. Which, I mean, Kim did in the inside with a nice catch, but. And then she can start trying to clean up. Ooh, Vanessa.
That's what the drop bears need. They are. For the sake of about 30 seconds of really good play from the Dodgy Bears, we're down 6 players to 3. People just stops as Lani goes to tie her shoelace up, but ends up being a bit of nothing. You tie it up or not?
This was unnecessary, but here we are.
So we've got 3.5 minutes left. Score is 4-3. It'll be very, very difficult. For the drop bears, if they take this set.
Drop bears definitely need to win this set if they want to have a chance to win.
Ooh.
Alyssa with a nice block up. Hesitated to go for it. Erica right there begging to try to run onto it.
Make my day. Don't you better just want to chip away here? They want to get this up to. They can take this to sudden death, let's say with a 3-1 player advantage. You know, they're in a very good spot to just close out the game.
Absolutely. Better yet, just with the set right now.
I mean, true, but then you're giving them a chance. So.
Yeah.
I think it's better putting the pressure all on one person to do a massive solo carry rather than the team to have a really quick set.
Yeah.
Probably want to speed it up a little bit. Oh, drop
Dropbears.
Gio seems to be trying to do. She took that shot with Vanessa before. Nice and quick. Tried to do the same with Lauren. Lauren went for the catcher's nest and she went for the dodge, which was the better option.
Gio again,
definitely looking to speed this
up. Knows the situation at hand. And just over 1 minute remaining in the game.
Free counter from Drew. Sliding sends one down the line. She sends hers down the middle. Stalemate. Three counters again. That's a good look. Didn't pay off, but that is a good look.
Absolutely.
You know? That pays off. It's a 4v4.
Yep.
You're back in to win this set, you know? And it hit the right spot. She was in the right position. Just didn't stick it. So, you know. 10 out of 10 for effort. Call of a 7 out of 10 for execution. Tiny bit better and it, you know, it's
complete, so.
I think Drew and Gio might have to be trying to look to do the same thing as we get close to the last minute, which will be the last set. Drew particularly, you know, it's right in her forte.
Not anymore.
Yeah, I think the first one may have just got a...
And it will be the last set.
So, Gio needs to 5-3-1.
Marcus pulling an out, I believe. 4-1
from Gio.